Developers tend to deploy production editions to test and develop, demonstrate certain things. For some reason, they're reluctant to use SQL Server Developer. It has a fantastic advantage. A few years ago, Microsoft made it completely free. All you need to do is you need to register yourself, create an account. Yeah, but we need features of SQL Server Enterprise. It is SQL Server Enterprise, branded as SQL Server Developer. That's what it is. It even has more features for developers. Why don't you? They deploy SQL Server Enterprise. Of course, you can have Visual Studio subscriptions to cover that. Of course, you can have MSDN platforms to cover for that. The problem with Visual Studio subscriptions and MSDN platforms is anyone, and I repeat that again, anyone, any admin, any backup operator, any other person, any other IT person that has access to that server, to maintain it, to back it up, to deploy policies, doesn't matter. Or imagine, just by default, all your IT department would have to be licensed with at least MSDN platforms. Well, actually, for SQL Server, Visual Studio Standard is the cheaper option. But you have to license everyone. Like, what's the cost of the Visual Studio Standard subscription? £300, $300. Multiplied by 100 people, that's what you pay, as opposed to free.